What's up, guys? Easy Eye Gaming here with a Kerbal Space Program episode. This is going to be episode one of hopefully a lot, actually. I hope to do a lot of this. It's a really fun game, and you could play a lot of it without even, like, leaving your seat. It's insane. It's, if you haven't heard of it, Kerbal Space Program is like a space simulation game. You could probably tell from the title. I believe it was made by NASA or something crazy like that, which it's insane. So we're gonna start a new career mode. We're gonna call it Easy Eye Gaming because I'm not creative at all, and I'm gonna press the left mouse button to start. Booyah. So we're loading here. I have played a little bit of this before. I've never really played career mode, though. I've played science and sandbox just to get to know the game a little bit, but career mode has, like, this whole reputation system, which is kind of a challenge in its own, so we'll see how far I can get with this. I have seen a couple Scott Manley videos, and so he is a great teacher, and let's see how great he did. So we're gonna call this cheat, because I'm about to freaking cheat and make all of you angry, because I'm like that. So basically, there's a science system in this game, and by earning science, you are able to unlock new parts and everything, and you gain science by basically just doing things like a crew report from certain places, or observing goo in random places, and also EVA, which is when you get out of your pod. And so you see here it says plus 5.6 science. So you just keep that, and then you just get right back in. And EVA report while flying over shores. Oh, so I guess EVA while holding onto the ladder counts as on the shore. But I'm going to do a little EVA report here, and that's on the ground from the launch pad. So I'm going to get back in, if it'll let me. B, board. Okay, so I'm going to hit recover vessel, and you'll see all the science that I earned pop up right here. So there's plus 1.5 science for the crew report from the launch pad, blah, 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 blah. So in all, I earned 12.5. So, and I also gained some funds, I think. So I'm going to go to our little science center and see here. This is where I can do all the basic unlocking of this tree that has basically all the unlockments in the game, which are pretty crazy. Like, look at this, a raper engine. Imagine using that in space, gosh. So I'm gonna buy these two with what I have. I think I have enough. Yeah, I have enough. And it really just allows me to make bigger, better rockets. And this is the place that I'm very out of sorts in. I really have no idea how this reputation thing works. So, go make a quick buck by selling exclusive research, right? Yeah, that's me. People use science. I'm pretty sure. Okay, so trading science for money, I don't think I'd want to do that. Public grant. I don't like any of these. No, I'm just gonna see how much I could do without that. But now, we're not gonna cheat anymore. We're gonna make a real freaking rocket. So let's just start from scratch. So we got this thing. Now let's go to fuel tanks. Let's put a buttload of these. Yeah, that's it. A buttload seems like a good amount. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'd say 6 is a buttload. And then we're gonna put one of these Reliant engines on, and then let's just do that. Let's not try to go past our own boundaries. So this is a little symmetry thing here. It helps me put two things at once. See, I put two there, and then we're gonna put a parachute on there because we don't want to die. And I think there's aerodynamic things here. We're gonna put a couple of those on just so that we don't flutter like a one-winged bird, which would be pretty ugly if you ask me. So we're gonna name this one-winged bird. And this baby's gonna fly like there's no tomorrow. Oh, I almost forgot staging. I don't want my parachute and my rocket going off at the same time. That would be pretty bad. Okay, so after watching my Sculpt Manly videos, I know how to take off quite well. So I'm gonna throttle all the way up and then enable my stabilization system. And then I'm going to press the big bar in the middle to rocket off. And here we go, on our way to outer space. We're going to see how high we can get. We just broke the world first speed record. I'd say that's pretty impressive. Look at this, we're all barely halfway out of fuel. We're already pretty dang high up. We look like a four-winged bird, if you ask me, because we are flying. Absolutely flying. Cue Star Trek music now. Weird. Okay, so now we're going to start falling down eventually, I think. This is our apoapsis, which is basically the top of our... Ooh, we just break orbit. We broke orbit. How about that? First freaking attempt, we broke orbit. We are now in the upper atmosphere, and you could tell that we broke orbit by the victory music playing in the background. That sounds like the Star Wars orchestra, because it's freaking awesome. So I'd say this was a pretty freaking good first launch, if you ask me, seeing that we're about to break 92 meters wouldn't reach the top of my fridge. So look at that space, all this space. We're gonna fly it all. We're gonna fly through all of it. So this really isn't gonna be interesting if we're just gonna go right back down. So let's do a little time warp. See, now we're going back down. Oh, really fast. Okay. We're on our way back down. And oh shoot, I should have done a crew report from up there, but I don't think I had space for it. Oh, parachute destroyed. Crap. That was a bad idea. We were going way too fast. And, Oh boy. Yeah, that's why you don't mess with rockets, guys.